Hello and welcome to the Cavern of Terror.
Eight-Legged Freak stars David Arquette, Scott Tara, Kari Wuerer, Scarlett Johansson, and is written and directed by Elria Alkayam. Our movie opens up, I think it's at night when this happens, and we have this trucker that is falling asleep at the wheel, and he's transporting this toxic waste, and what happens is a bunny hops out onto the road, and he swerves, and one of the barrels ends up in a town's water supply. I really don't see how anything bad can happen from that. If you guys don't really know me, if you just discovered this channel, I really don't like spiders. I just don't like spiders. It started with the Resident Evil games. I became terrified of spiders. I turned into a Spartan from the 300 movie when I found one in my old apartment. It just wasn't a good time for me. So naturally, I decided that it was a perfect idea to review a movie about giant spiders invading a town. What have I done? So, with the nightmare fuel portion of the video out of the way, for now, at least until I start talking about spiders again, let's talk about a positive. Scott Tara. Scott Tara was a younger actor at the time in the early 2000s when this movie was being made, and I thought he did a really good job here. He's actually the youngest actor in this movie, and he plays Mike. He is the son of Kari Wuerer's sheriff character of this small town, and I thought he did very well with what he was given here. He sort of plays the character that really knows what's going on when everyone else tries to tell him that he doesn't know what's going on. Always listen to the kid in these kind of movies, and that actually kind of happens in this movie. It's really smart writing on the part of this movie here by making the kid the smartest character in the movie, but I really enjoyed his performance here. And fun fact, he's actually young Matt Murdock in the Ben Affleck Daredevil movie. Scarlett Johansson actually does very well in one of her earlier roles. This is one of the first movies I remember seeing her in, and wow, I'm old. Johansson really is good in the smaller character role that she plays in this movie. She's not really a big star yet, so she doesn't have a lot of screen time in Eight-Legged Freaks. But most importantly, guys, let's talk about David Arquette. Our main character in Eight-Legged Freaks enters this movie like a gangster.
Old man McCormick said he found gold in those mines before he died. I'm David Arquette, and I'm the baddest motherfucker in this movie.
David Arquette, and I'm the baddest motherfucker in this movie. All joking aside, guys, I am a huge Scream fan. I reviewed all the movies on this channel. You want to go over there and check those reviews out, be my guest. I would appreciate it if you dropped a like if you checked them out. Got the mask back here behind me. And I'm actually very, very happy that this movie made an attempt at making David Arquette a leading man. Eight-Legged Freaks was shortly after Scream 3, the supposed final movie in that franchise at this point, so that is exactly what they were trying to do. That being said here, guys, I actually really did enjoy him here in this leading role. I sort of got a Tom Hanninger, Jensen Eccles vibe from My Bloody Valentine, the remake that I reviewed earlier way back on this channel, of the prodigal son, you know, returning to set things right in his hometown.
It's an invasion!
We have arrived. It is that time. Guys, are there any haw moments in Eight-Legged Freaks? Well, unfortunately, no, there isn't. But Sheriff is kind of hot. Come on, man. You said you were going to stop joking around. I'm actually kind of looking at my fish. In all seriousness, I really did enjoy Kari Wuerer's character of the Sheriff, and she brings a sort of wholesomeness to this with her character of being a mother on top of the sheriff, and she does bring her own sort of edge of badassness as well. And shout out to my debtor fans, at least there weren't any chains in her face here. Eight-legged Freaks, in all intents and purposes, really is an old-school creature monster movie with a fresh coat of new millennium paint. They hit all the points that you are sure to hit in an old-school monster movie. Old school characters. Check. No way to send help. Check. Badass creature designs. Check. Speaking of the creatures, aka the spiders, this is really something that's going to make or break Eight-Legged Freaks for a lot of people. Are there practicals? You guys know that I love practicals. Are there practicals here? Yeah, in a way. Kinda, yeah, they're here. This nod to the, you know, the old school era 50s monster films, it really doesn't use the practicals as much as it should. It uses a lot of CGI. Is it bad? No, not really. I would really rank it above, you know, sci-fi, asylum type stuff. I don't really think it's like PS2 level. I'd say it's maybe GameCube level. And you know what? A lot of those GameCube games had pretty good graphics. I'd say that it is dated, but it's not so bad that it will take you out of the movie. There's a lot of liquid here, and liquid is really, really hard to animate in CGI. That brings me to a point that I usually make in a lot of these horror movie reviews. Would this movie have been better with more practicals? Yes, yes, it would have. Yes, there are practicals here. We get a lot of like big legs and small legs and some spider webs and some corpses of spiders later in the third act. But there's so little, there's so few and far between of actual practicals in this, it seems kind of pointless. They should have either went CGI or they should have went full practicals. Now, this didn't have a small budget. This was, I believe, a $30 million film. That's a lot of money. This had big producers behind it. And I think, you know, it would have been better with practicals. I just think it would have been better with practicals. Do you guys remember that part in The Amazing Spider-Man 2? You know, that movie that everybody hated that I kind of liked, saw it in theaters, thought it was pretty badass. That part where Electro was throwing Spider-Man into the Tesla coils and it was making that Itsy Bitsy Spider song play out? Alien Freaks did that before, and I think they did it better. While the song itself isn't blatantly being played as the spiders are, you know, attacking someone, they sort of mix it into the score, which is really cool, and they, like, alter the song structure to make you hear what you want to hear, but also hear that score as well. It's really creepy. It shows you that the spiders are here, and they mean business. So the score gets one of these. There was something that really bothered me here with the story, and it has a couple of storylines here that don't really get resolved. One of them involves the mayor, and the other one involves the mayor's son, and it just would have made for a movie with more depth if those stories would have been developed more, and I think it would have added a little bit more weight. Unfortunately, I have another negative with Eight-Legged Freaks, and take it how you will. I've said that film is subjective on this channel so many times, and it really is. There is a tonal change in the third act of this movie. Admittedly, there are some creepy, if not scary, scenes in the first and second act of this film. But near the third act is when everything changes. They sort of shift into this very cheesy, corny, comedic tone, and I really don't think it works at all. I know, when you look this movie up on IMDb or Wikipedia, it will say horror comedy. And there is some comedy in the first and second acts, but it's very dark, you know? Dry comedy at the very beginning, you know what I mean? Some comedy that you have to look for. In the third act, it is blatantly in your face, and I just wasn't here for it. It's a little too much, guys. I came here for the scares. In the end, guys, I'm gonna have to give Eight-Legged Freaks a... If you guys like old school monster movies and movies that pay homage to those movies, especially with the dirt bike scene, you guys are going to love Eight-Legged Freaks. It's got some really cool, chilling sequences, especially in the first and second acts, and some pretty strong performances, specifically from David Arquette. I thought he was great in this movie. If you want my personal opinion, digging a little bit deeper here, I think this movie is a perfect example of a film that deserves a sequel. You know, give us a couple more, you know, different kinds of spiders. Could you imagine giant wolf spiders or black widows or daddy long legs? I know we got that in Honey, We Shrunk Ourselves, I think, but I think it would be cool to have some different kinds of spiders in a sequel. You know, bring back David Arquette. I think it would be really interesting and up those scares. And fun fact, in 2003, they did announce that they were going to make an Eight-Legged Freaks 2. And those plans kind of fell to the wayside. There hasn't been any announcements since. All right, guys, that has been my review of Eight-Legged Freaks. What do you guys think of this monster movie? Let me know down in the comments down below. And by the way, what is your favorite David Arquette movie? Let me know that down in the comments down below as well. If you like this video, make sure you give it a like. It really helps the channel, guys. It really does. With that YouTube algorithm, if you like these videos, more people will see them. YouTube will promote my content. We're almost to that 1,000 subs, boy. Let's get it. And while we're on that point, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell. That way you get notified about all my future content. Make sure you hit all for notifications. That way you guys know that I'm putting out content. Really, really helps the channel if you like and subscribe to the page. Whoa, where are you going? Don't click away yet. You've got plenty of time to watch my other badass videos. We're not done here yet. Back in the day on my channel, I used to do like collection archive videos where I would do things that I picked up, you know, movies and stuff like that. And it's been a while since I've done one of those videos. And the reason for that being, I haven't really picked up a whole lot of stuff recently. So I did want to tell you at the end of this video that I finally got a Holy Grail item for the set. It has to be here. It has to be here, guys. It has to. It absolutely has to. If you know me, you know why it has to. I got a pop figure, okay? It's a Legion M pop figure, and it's a Holy Grail item. Guys, look here. I have a Red Miller Mandy pop figure. That's right, guys. I have a Nicolas Cage pop figure. If you know anything about my channel, I'm a huge Nicolas Cage fan. 70 titles and counting. So guess what? This guy going right over here on top of Ghostface. Here we go. Red looks pretty badass up there, doesn't he? Guess I'm gonna have to review Mandy sometime soon. Okay, alright, guys, that's it. That's it for the video. But most importantly, guys, you can find me on social media. All those links are in the description box. But most importantly, I'm Zach. This has been the Cavern of Terror. Stay metal, my friends.